My name is Vibhor. I studied engineering in my bachelor's. After that, I worked in business development, post which I worked for Teach for India, and then I joined IIHS. I used to hang a lot with architecture seniors and batchmates, and they were usually interested in a lot of planning and urban related stuff, and I had no clue about it. But because I had very interdisciplinary interests, they kept talking to me about how this might be a great place for me to join, and that's how I came to know about the fellowship. I wanted to understand why cities, as well as, like, not particularly cities, but why the system works the way it does. And I knew at least that because it's a fellowship focusing on the urban, the approach would start from the cities. But the way the course was laid out in its description on the site, it was clear that it's trying to create an approach towards a complex issue rather than understanding the particular phenomena, in this case, the city. Yeah, so I was basically trying to understand why state projects and why development projects fail in its operations. Why do we spend a lot of money on things that don't work? And as a people and as the structure of our democracy, how it's functioning the way it is. Approaching it from the city's lens, it kind of fairly rooted all these things into some particular city, some particular scheme, some particular project. And just by exploring those things, I was able to clearly understand why things work in some places, why they don't. More than that, it was about the approach towards these topics and these issues. It's a formative course, I would say. So it allows the fellow to create an approach, create a sensibility, rather than having specialized knowledge. So it's about an integration of all different aspects. And that's what makes us contemporary, because the way things are happening right now, they are no more strictly happening in their disciplinary domains. The box lids are open and everything's mixed together. So the contemporary part of it comes from its integration across all these boundaries. It was too fast in the beginning. Like, the common started with planning and identity, and I have no background in either. And particularly a lack of background as well as a lack of direct interest also hindered reception very at the early stages. But as we moved on, I understood why they were the first set of modules, because they kind of form a layer towards over which everything else can be built and understood. And as we followed from there to economy, governance, ecology and infrastructure, you could see all these themes playing out in the economy, where Indian economy in particular is more informal, unorganized. And these issues have come up in my practica, in my exposure visit, and even in the applications that I'm making for internships. It's clear that India is, like, as a governance mechanism, we are trying to understand the phenomena of informality and how to make a relationship with this large set of livelihood which is employing bulk of our people. And from there to practica, where it gave us direct exposure, understanding the way communities live in a city and how do they go about their life on a daily basis. And from there to the exposure visit, where we could see a lot of what we studied culminate into the form of a city and the history of the city. Like, I went to Mumbai and I could see the history of mill worker movements, mill unions, riders standing at the Phoenix Mills Mall. And although I hadn't visited the Phoenix Mills compound before, but I'm pretty sure even if I had, I would never notice the way the structure and actually is a remnant of a larger point of history. From there to the projects that we are doing, it again puts us in touch with how what we study needs to happen in the real world, and how do we connect all of this learning towards creating a productive output. they moderated it very well. So they never gave us easy answers. They told us to hold our questions and think of those as we moved across the whole course. A lot of fellows had strong orientation, strong disciplinary scope, bounds, biases. And just by the sheer experience, I guess, which the faculty has, they were able to put these things, like settle them down and help everyone explore beyond these specific frames. Well, I was working with a planner, an architect, a designer, and a sociologist, and we ate each other's head off because it was hard for everyone at first to come out of their disciplinary backgrounds, understand why some particular thing is relevant in the discussion that's happening right now. So how the dimension of caste plays out in water security, and how just being able to live at a location in Bangalore required a whole lot of political negotiation. And understanding those things from a technical background is different. And explaining the technicalities to someone coming from a humanities background, just moving across that bridge again and again and again and again, that kind of brought the approach to reality. That, so okay, we understand the interdisciplinary approach, but how does it play out in real life? And what do we exactly mean by it? It means having these conversations across disciplines and across specialties and trying to understand something to the best of our abilities, having all these different set of ideas in the room. It's been a roller coaster. And it's not as if I have changed. It's not as if my thinking has changed. More, it's been a broadening of some sort, wherein now I can approach and think about the same issues that frustrate me, that pain me. But now I have these angles to look about it and try to, I have a way to create knowledge about those things and talk about things in a way that can lead to positive outcomes. And across all these experiences, I guess there has been a connectivity and an emphasis on relevance, that everything that we do, everything that we read, everything that we say must finally address something that's reality in the ground and has been a part of either our lived experiences or someone else's out there. I think this is one thing very specific to IIHS as well. You have all kind of people working here as a part of the team. You have people writing, you have people filming, you have people designing. And it's a, so it flows out from there. And it's interesting because I got to see that decision-making, governance, they don't only operate out of a single mathematical or logic-based structure. There is more experience attached to it. And this, I don't know if it's empathy or if it's addition of subjectivity in my lens, more rather than less, that now when I'm approaching a particular situation, I'll think about not just the human experience of it, but a whole lot of society that goes in the background, the part of culture. And so these aspects, I don't think they come directly when we enter a particular disciplinary education. And public tests, screenings, having photographers from different countries come and project their work, and how do they see the city? And that allows us to understand beyond doing. It gives more experience and roots, talks about the lived experience of the city as well. Ecology. So it was the last module that we were taught. And because we were seeing that cities are a new phenomena, like 2000, 3000, 6000 years old. And when we were taken across the ride from the beginning of the universe towards multiple extinctions that species have faced, towards the ecological conditions that have led to life as we know it. And then we finally see cities in that context, the idea of sustainability becomes obvious. You don't think about sustainability as something that is an opponent of development or an opponent of progress or of economy. You see it as something that's the most logical thing to do. And I think it was a good way to close the commons and then move into the elective cycle, where I took climate, urban risk and resilience, and digital labor. So all these, this particular elective kind of gave me a bedrock and led me to think about how, you know, I want to give my time. Like, how do I define my career and towards what? That's a question I've been struggling with for a while, because I want to do something which is closer to implementation, where I can see not exactly a change, but if I'm a part of a process, then I can see that process in iteration and in action, and I can see where it's failing and where it's succeeding. And from those failures and successes, I can learn from how am I designing these processes. So like right now, I've applied to a couple of places, and I'm one of my offers is to work towards helping people create social enterprises. So there I see the learning of informality and of governance and of ecology coming in, and seeing how these businesses can address the larger issues of ecology, but also operate with the government in a certain way by making claims towards their legitimacy, even though being from an unorganized or informal sector. Clear expectations is interesting, because I walked in with an empty cup, and I walked in with a faith that these people will deliver what they are talking about. If the future candidates are applying because they genuinely want to go beyond the disciplinary boundaries and don't have a very specific output that they're looking out for. So like, you know, you usually do an MBA because at the end of it, you know you're going to get a job at certain kind of roles. And I would advise that UFP is not the same ballgame. It's a different thing. It will enable the candidate in a different way and for a different set of outcomes. Not in the short term, not as if everyone can come in, get a job after this, and you know, everything's happy-go-lucky after it. So it's more, as I previously said, a formative experience, and it, I think, will lead to results in a longer term rather than just moving out of fellowship.